college are thanks to Huddles, who, as you see there, just was the main conductor of the school. So the vet school is really, really fortunate that we've got a number of hugely talented musicians and singers. Now, unfortunately, they can't be with us here tonight, and we're left later, but I jest. This is a group that we're so incredibly proud of. First of all, I have just a bit of a boring bit, and that's the health and safety and the phones, as you can understand. Now, under health and safety tonight, we've got a lot of shy children in here, as you've seen, okay? So, should there be a fire, they'll probably have started it, so just head straight. No, please, where your exit is. Obviously, this is just a normal health and safety announcement. And because we're filming this and streaming it, we're filming it for nostalgia, which I'll explain in a moment. Can I please make sure that all your mobile phones are turned off or turned to silent? That would be greatly appreciated. So when I was in school, I asked in geography, my teacher said, why do the Germans make great cars? And the answer was tradition. Why do Irish people breed great horses? And the answer again is tradition. So this is the 40th anniversary of the Carol Service here within the vet school. And there's been a long passage of people passing on the skill sets and everything that's been learned from one year to the next. So tradition is one of the reasons why, as you're about to see tonight, and it's great to have such a fantastic number of people here tonight, a great, great night's entertainment and a huge amount of effort put in by all the staff and all the students. So I hope without further ado, you just enjoy the evening. Thank you.
Ring, 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 ring
Okay, folks, everybody in life answers to somebody. So this is the man I answer to. I can introduce our dean and head of school, the very wise Michael Darby.
Guru Magad, Rory is our clinical director in the hospital, and he's also a really impressive foreign tea, so Guru Mila Magad, but while I'm so falso war, a curve and Shaw knocked, Shaw Ihi at an special to doing the skull trade league. It's a very special night. It's always a special night, but because it's the 40th anniversary makes it really, really special. And I'd like to welcome you all, everyone, all the students, all the staff. Retired members of staff, and Tahir Leona Gilling, the Falsha World Roads, colleagues from all over the country, really, and people who have travelled far and wide. And, you know, it's Eamon Fitzpatrick, who's here, actually. He's over in this side of the building. He was one of the people who began the Carol Service 40 years ago in Ballsbridge, and some of these lovely photographs that have been circulated, you can see him. And I want to acknowledge him, and George Hilton, who was one of the early members of the choir, former deans, Grace Mulcahy sang in the choir, Michael Monaghan sang in the choir, Michael Doherty sang in the choir. not very well. But you know, it also is, I was thinking, Ihan the Givenia. There's lots of memories, actually. I was thinking about that, Paul's Bridge, because I'm thinking of people who are no longer with us. In particular, I'm thinking of Professor Tommy McGeady, who was just a great supporter of our Carol Service. I'm thinking of Professor Dan Collins, who was a great supporter. I saw a photograph of Dahi Conway, who was a great supporter. So these are people who ata erchli na fairinia. There'll be a lot of thanks and we has a goal in that, but at this stage I really want to thank Felicity Fitzpatrick and all of the VetSoc team. Would you give them a round of applause, even at this stage, because we're done in the morning. I mean, the choir are just wonderful, and Christine Kahn is just doing a wonderful job with Poodles, and Emer O'Donoghue and Sarah McTiernan, Bulla Bus, Dives and Fresh and Lower Dull. We have our trad group led by Kathy Powered, Damien Bannon. We have artwork for the poster, Kelly Chamberlain, Augustiniella, and I'm sure we'll get opportunities to thank them as the evening goes on. It's a funny time of year, you know, the dark evening's closing and people are all, there's a bit of pressure on their people. Students are under pressure coming up to exams. We're all feeling a bit of it at the moment. But let's just relax tonight. Let's just relax and enjoy the music, because this is something very, very unique to the Vet School. And I'm very proud to be the dean of the Vet School that puts this show on. And I think we're going to have a group of musicians now that are close friends of mine. I think I'm going to join them for a little while to see how we get on. So I got to meet them out.
Okay, so as Michael pointed out, this is the 40th year. And we thought a really special treat was to bring back the band who actually performed 40 years ago. Okay? Don't knock it. When I was a student, their pictures were on the walls. They were a source of inspiration to me, okay? And tonight we've got the O'Shea's. We've Tim Geraghty, who came from Scotland, especially for this, which proves two things. Number one, obviously. It proves the dedication of people who took part. It also proves that he has a very low boredom threshold, if this is the way he decided to spend his Thursday evening. But also we've got Justin Ward, we've got Anne Healy, we've got Michael Doherty, as I said, we've just got a large group of people, whatever, and literally they wanted to do this presentation. They're called the LAX group, Large Animal Clinical Studies. It's an old folk group, whatever, okay? Be charitable and listen to them, whatever. Away you go, folks.
So Jeremiah, good Rory. Shall I go over there? Yeah, okay. Christmas must be tonight. Thank you. to the manger, see the little stranger, wrapped in swaddling clothes, the Prince of Peace. We'll start turning, torches start burning, and behold the wise men journey from the east. How a little baby boy brings the people so much joy. Son of a carpenter, Mary carry the light. This must be Christmas, must be tonight.
Shepherd on the hillside, flock I by. On a cold winter's night, a band of angels sing. In a dream I heard a voice said, fear not, come rejoice. It's the end of the beginning, praise the newborn King.
Christmas must be
Okay, folks, you've got to admit they still have it, okay? Much and all, as I hate to admit it, whatever. Thanks very much, it was fantastic. Any funds that are generated this evening, and you will have seen a couple of collection buckets, are going to be divided between the DSPCA and our own Animal Welfare Fund. Now, the DSPCA is an organisation that's very important to us here because they act like an adjunct facility where a lot of our students go to do a lot of their clinical work, and we're extraordinarily grateful for the input and the collaboration for that. So first of all, I'd just like to introduce Brian Gillen, who's the Chief Executive of the DSPCA, to say a few words.
Thank you very much, Rory. Well, for me, it's a little bit like a trip down memory lane coming back here tonight. I actually graduated from here. This is my alma mater. I didn't, in fact, study veterinary like you guys. I did a BCom and went on to become a chartered accountant. As you can see, I've changed a little bit my line of career. But I'm a bit like the Monty Python sketch where the chartered accountant goes in for the interview to become a lion tamer. You know, I've become where I'm running an animal welfare organisation, so that's where I've ended up. No, I've. It's a big year this coming year as well for the DSPCA. We're established 180 years ago. My role is I'm really very much a caretaker of everything that has led us to this point, and hopefully we're managing to hold the whole operation together going into the next few years. We deal exclusively with sick, injured and cruelly treated animals. In terms of the types of animals we have, we deal with literally everything. So horses right through to mice. That's the range of species we deal with. I'd have to say, I didn't start on the first day 180 years ago. I'm there 8 years at this stage. And I just see a lot of goodness up there. I see a lot of people trying to do a lot of good for the animals. We couldn't do the work we do without the help of a lot of our partners. UCD, I would see as our partners and friends at this stage. We're delighted that the students work with us, but you do so much good in helping us to just help more and more animals. I think relationships have built up over the years between us all here. Rory has, the first thing he said to me about tonight, and I was delighted to come to a musical evening, was that he asked me, could I sing? And I said, of course. So there's a bet on this, so if you wouldn't mind joining in with me, Rory's going to give me 20 quid. And if you've ever got 20 off Rory, I'd like to shake your hand, you know? So I'm going to give a go with something. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white. There must be at least 30 quid there. Thank you. Happy Christmas. Thank you all very much.
Literally, that man will do anything for 20 euro, okay? Very briefly, the Animal Welfare Fund. My generation always looks at this generation and calls them the snowflake generation, that they've no coping skills, they can't do this, they can't do the other. But we had quite a philosophical debate a short while ago where we all recognised, people of my age, that this generation is a generation who cares far more about climate change, homelessness and animal welfare than our generation probably ever did. And that's an incredibly important sign and hopeful sign for the future. The Animal Welfare Fund is the students giving money again and again to allow for the treatment of animals who come to the hospital where the owner genuinely can't afford it. And I'm going to give you a bit of a surprising statistic. There's quite a sum of money in it, because what shocks me is every year, event after event, they just keep doing it again and again, and some of them pay due credit to the students. So all I wanted to say was the fund exists, but I want to pay thanks to the students for all the efforts they make to try and actually generate the funds for it. Other than that, we're going to hand straight over back to Christina and her group. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Asleep on the hay, the cattle are low.
Jesus, no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky and stay by my bedside till morning is nigh. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay close by me forever and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care and lead us to heaven to live with thee there.
Just cannot grow beneath.
Thank you very much, folks. Two people who are incredibly important to the school are Niamh Nestor, who's our student advisor, and Father Leon, who obviously is our chaplain. Now, Niamh unfortunately can't be here tonight because she's sick, which, as all of us will know, means she must be on a life support, because she would never miss this. She also sees this as a really positive thing. So without further ado, if I can ask for Father Leon to come up and say a few words.
Goramagat Rory, thank you very much. And Goramagat Mihola Doherty, who could have passed the Dom Chatnacha, con Lart live enough. And happy Christmas to you all before I begin. Just very recently, I was watching a wildlife program which followed the habits of snub-nosed monkeys. Now, I don't know if they're part of your repertoire of study here in the School of Veterinary Medicine. They're way up in the Himalayas, and I believe they were only discovered in the 1960s. Their snub noses evolved to protect them against frostbite because they're so high up, 4,000 meters above sea level. When winter approaches, most animals that high up start their descent down the mountains, but these start going up. And this has intrigued scientists, and so they started following their habits and documenting it. They climb up the most harsh and most inimical terrain on Earth. And they live off the lichens, the frozen lichens off trees, and the little monkeys curl around the fur of their mothers to keep warm, and they manage to get up there. Up where? The scientists wonder, why do they go up rather than down? The reason is what lies above. By the end of winter and the beginning of spring, they reach their destination. And in this documentary, it was fascinating to see. They reach a paradise of tropical plants, colorful rhododendrons with their sweet-tasting nectar, all this made possible by a funnel of tropical air that makes its way up at springtime up through the Himalayas, up to that part of it. At the end of this documentary, you see the snub-nosed monkeys swinging from branch to branch in a dance of ecstasy as they fill their bellies with food in plenty and without any competition from predators, because all those took the easier route and went down, whereas they were going up. What I found fascinating about the documentary was their collective primordial memory that instinctively drew them upward in what can only be described as an agonizing climb to a place of plenty that they knew, that they believed, that they trusted awaited them. Now, in this festive season of Christmas, whether we are Christians or not, the innocent crib of Bethlehem, I think, invites us once again to ponder the mystery of God's descent to us, to earth, which makes possible our ascent to paradise. It is a time for all of us to dig deep into our unconscious and to try to discern there our deepest longing as human beings, our profoundest hope, our wish for a world of uninterrupted beauty and tranquility, of peace and of plenty. When this memory, this unconscious memory, this desire is awakened, our ascent, hard as it can be at times, becomes full of joyful anticipation. The story of Bethlehem warms our hearts. It keeps us going. It fills our imaginations with the possibility of a new heaven and a new earth. And indeed, I believe that we make it real at Christmas time, even for a brief moment, by our joyful and generous outpouring of goodwill to both friend and foe during the Christmas season. It's the season of goodwill. And so, in conclusion, I wish you all the joy and the peace of Christmas always, and a reawakening of that memory that points decisively to a paradise lost, but also found. Molly Connor Yves Gadair. Spanach Dair.
Good people, all this Christmas time, consider well and bear in mind what our good God for us has done in sending His beloved Son.
With Mary holy we should pray to God with love this Christmas day. In Bethlehem upon that morn there was a blessed Messiah born.
Near Bethlehem did shepherds keep their flocks of lambs and feeding sheep, to whom God's angels did appear, which put the shepherds in great fear.
Prepare and go, the angel said, to Bethlehem, be not afraid, for there you'll find this happy morn, a princely babe, sweet Jesus born.
With thankful heart and joyful mind, the shepherds went this babe to find. And as God's angel had foretold, they did our Savior Christ behold.
Within a manger He was laid, and by His side a virgin maid, attending on the Lord of life, who came on earth to end all strife.
Good people, all this Christmas time, consider well and bear in mind what our good God for us has done in sending His beloved Son. With Mary holy we should pray to God. Lord, hey there, we're near.
All the final years, please.
Thank you.
Okay, folks. What you have to admit is you've got a rather eclectic mix there of Christmas carols and kind of alternative music. But the heart that drives all the student events is VetSoc. And these are groups of students who come together to organise everything for the student body. And again, it involves a huge amount of time and a huge amount of effort. And they do a phenomenal job. So here to say a few words on behalf of VetSoc, I'm going to welcome Felicity.
Fáilte of Galera Cairde. My name is Felicity Fitzpatrick, and I am the auditor of the Veterinary Society. I hope you've all enjoyed our carol service so far. This is by far one of my favourite events in the vet school calendar, mainly because it highlights how close we are as a school. I don't know any other faculty in UCD that has such a strong sense of community and in which the staff and students get along so well. I'm glad you all got a taste of that tonight. There are a few people I would like to thank, because without them, tonight would not have been possible. Firstly, to the choir, who have been singing carol service since September, not what you'd expect to hear on the first week back. Especially to Ruth, Emer, Christine, and Sarah, who have worked so hard all semester. I think you'd all agree with me that they were simply brilliant. Thank you as well to Damien Bannon and Kathy Power and the entire trad group. Yous are as brilliant as ever. I actually share a room with Kathy, and I don't know how I'm going to sleep at night from now on with her renditions of Red is the Rose at 2 o'clock in the morning. To our speakers, our Dean, Professor Michael Doherty, who it also transpires as a talented musician, who knew? And to Father Leon, it was really lovely to have you both here tonight. It wouldn't be a veterinary carol service without our MC, Rory Bratnock, who always manages to entertain us on the night. Thank you also to Brian Gillen from the DSPCA for taking your time out to speak to us. And for the surprise song, it was brilliant. Lastly, thank you to the rest of our VetSoc team who work so hard to make events like this happen. They're an absolutely brilliant team. Unfortunately, our wonderful student advisor, Niamh Nestor, couldn't be here, as Rory said, but I've been told she's watching along on the live stream upstairs, so at least she's getting to see it. Now, I have to say, I was slightly nervous about tonight. With it being the big 40th anniversary, everyone is expecting something bigger and better, and I wasn't sure how we were going to improve on the last 2 years, which were pretty perfect. When I heard that we were going to have a guest appearance from some of our lecturers, that nervousness increased slightly, especially when I heard that there was an electric guitar involved. But I needn't have worried. The LACS group really made the night one to remember. Being involved in this event has been a really extraordinary experience and reminds me once again how lucky we are to be part of such a warm, friendly and talented community. Mara Jaron Chanakal, Isir Scott Akela, Awari Nadini. Thank you all for coming tonight and please join us for mulled wine and mince pies afterwards. Nulakana Dave Galair, Gurmila Mahagat, Augustana Walla.
Thank you.
again.
Benedict. tica domino salus regi nostro.
Gaudete, gaudete, Christus es natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete. Gaudete, gaudete, Christus es natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete.
Can I just say a couple of last words before we split up? Basically, we're a very small profession, and Felicity put it perfectly. You don't get other schools where the students, the staff, and the families come together. And I think on behalf of the choir, to have such a turnout and such an incredible reception is really heartwarming for them. But equally, from the perspective of people listening to you, and I think I'm speaking on behalf of everybody here, I know a sense of responsibility comes on your shoulders, where you want it to work really well, you want to organize it, you just want it to work on the night, okay? And all I can tell you, as somebody who listened to this, whatever, it worked phenomenally well. And people say be modest, but sometimes forget modesty. You were fantastic. And on behalf of everybody, thank you so much. Without further ado, it's really nice if people stay behind, as you said, for some mulled wine and mince pies just to meet and to chat. Students have exams coming up, so they'll head to the library, but the rest of us can enjoy it all. Happy Christmas, folks, okay? Thank you very much.